The popular photo editing software Affinity Photo has received a new update, bringing for the first time to Affinity's design software suite, AI-powered tools. In this video, we'll take a look at these new tools, as well as how Serif, the company behind Affinity Photo, chose to implement them, as it's a different strategy than what I've seen from other software companies adding AI to their software. Now first, if you're not familiar, Affinity Photo is a professional, fully featured photo editing program available for Mac and Windows, and it's my personal choice for photo editing. It's positioned as an excellent economical alternative to Adobe Photoshop. Affinity Photo is purchased as a one-time license, different to Adobe's much more expensive monthly subscription model. And don't think the cheaper price means it's not a professional program. Affinity Photo is a fully featured photo editing program with features like layers, masks, adjustments, pixel and vector editing, and raw image processing. The version 2.6 update of Affinity Photo brings two new AI, or more specifically machine learning, powered tools to the program. These are the Object Selection Tool and Select Subject Tool. With these tools, you can simply select an object or feature in a photo by first selecting the Object Selection Tool, waiting a bit for the app to process your photo. Now this step can take a couple minutes in my experience. And then you can hover over the photo to see with the blue colored hatching which area you'd like to select. Then click an area to select it. Much like other selection tools, you can also use the options above to add or subtract from your selection. You can use the Select Subject tool to select the subject of the photo in a couple clicks. Go to Select, then Select Subject. These tools are a great addition to Affinity Photo's toolset, in my opinion, as previously, making selections was done by having to manually select items using the Selection Brush tool or the Selection tool to draw around the object to be selected. Affinity Photo's unique approach to AI is also worth mentioning. Unlike other software I've seen that have added AI features, Affinity Photo is not trying to push these AI tools and make it front and center. Rather, Affinity Photo first does not ever call it AI, instead opting to call it machine learning, which is the more precise technical term for the kind of artificial intelligence being used here. Second, this feature is not available by default. To enable it, you'll need to go to the App Settings, select Machine Learning, and download the machine learning models, one for each tool, to enable this feature. And as you can see from this download requirement, Affinity Photo's approach to machine learning is completely on device. Affinity Photo makes clear that no data is being sent to their servers or some other third-party server to fulfill the request. Rather, everything is being done on device, which, in addition to letting you use this feature without an internet connection, it also should give you some added assurance that your work is not being sent to some server on the internet to be used as training data for an AI model. There are some minimum computer requirements to use this feature. According to Affinity Photo's support documentation, for Windows PCs, you'll need to be on either Windows 10 or 11 with either an x64 or ARM-based PC. For macOS, you'll need a Mac running Apple Silicon and macOS 13 Ventura or newer. Older Macs with Intel processors cannot use this feature. To use the Object Selection tool, first make sure the layer with the photo you'd like to select within is selected. Click the Object Selection tool from the tool menu on the left. You'll see this clock icon that the tool is loading and processing the photo. For example, I ran this a few times on my laptop and it took from 40 seconds to 1 minute and 20 seconds. Since this is an on-device process, I want to think a computer with more processing power and more RAM would be able to do this machine learning process faster. Once it completes the processing of the photo, your cursor will be this cross, and you can move around the photo to see the objects it has detected for you to select, highlighted with the blue hatched area. So for example, if I'd like to select the green Android robot in this photo, I'll move my cursor here and click. It'll then take a few moments to select this object, and now you'll see this area of the photo is now selected. It will now switch to the Add Selection option, which you can tell either from the options above here, or that the highlighted area now uses the color green. So I can, for example, add to my selection this pickleball by clicking it here, and now it's selected. You can also use this tool to deselect areas. We'll switch to this option by clicking its option here from the toolbar above. Now, for example, let's say I want to deselect the holes in the pickleball. I'll click one of the holes and click it. And now it's deselected. Now you'll see when we select another hole, it isn't separating the hole from the rest of the pickleball. And I find this to be a use case where you can use the Alt key, or Option key on Mac, to select a component within an object. Now that I'm holding the Alt key, I can now select this hole of the pickleball to deselect it from the current selection. I can then repeat this process to select other holes of this pickleball. We can also see this can handle more unique shapes, such as this plant. I'll switch back to the Add option, and as I move over the plant, you'll see I can select the vase. Next, I'll select the plant itself. I'll then select the area between the plant and vase. You'll see it hasn't selected everything, however, what I can do now is switch to the regular rectangle marquee tool to add this area to my selection. Let's now create a mask from this to hide everything not selected. Now, we can zoom in here to see how it handles the edges. As you can see, it does a fairly good job at selecting around the robot. Some minor touch-up may be needed around the arms, but a good starting point. As for the plant, again, it does a good job of selecting along the irregular shape of the plant. Overall, it does pretty good at selecting objects. The Select Subject tool is intended to provide you an option to select the key subject in just a couple clicks. To use it, go to Select, then Select Subject. Much like the other tool, I had this take a couple of minutes to process the photo. However, from my experience, this tool appears only good at selecting people, and struggles if the key subject of the photo is something else. For example, in this photo, it selects me in the photo correctly. However, in this other photo, it also selects me mostly correctly. Though it interestingly only selects me, it doesn't even select my backpack or my hat in my hand. We can easily fix this though by using the Object Selection tool, and since the photo has already been processed, we don't need to wait, and then click these objects to add it to the selection. However, results are not great for photos of not people. For this one, it selects the top of the plant and the book in the background for some reason, and it does not select the white vase of the plant. Thinking the white vase on the light-colored background may have been too difficult, I had it select the subject of this photo of the same plant with a wood background. And the result is it selecting the plant and the decorative element in the background. I then used the tool with a photo of just a green robot on a wood table. And the Select Subject tool proceeded to select the robot, and then also much of the table. Again, not what I wanted. Overall, if the key subject is a person, then you can use the Select Subject tool and refine your selection using the Object Selection tool. Otherwise, just use the Object Selection tool. In summary, it's great to see Serif adding new useful tools to Affinity Photo, and these two are welcome additions. The object selection tool is something I see myself using, letting me select parts of a photograph to apply adjustment layers to, as well as to select an object in a photo to remove the background. Thanks for watching. Until next time.